This is the Satin Lounge. Breathe it in. That was Raining Words by tonight's guests joining us right now for Pillow Talk. We're going across the water tonight to bring you a fearless indie artist from Namibia who uses her music as a platform to address social issues. Recently, her song Minority was nominated for Best Music Video at the 2013 Namibian Annual Music Awards, and she's an international inspiration in the LGBT community, and she's here tonight. Satin Lounge, please help me welcome indie singer-songwriter Shoshani. Hello.
Hello, hello.
Thank you so much for joining us tonight and vibing as we kind of get comfortable on our pillows and join you for some pillow talk. Thank you for being here.
For sure. Thank you for having me.
Yeah, you're a Namibian native. Am I saying that word correctly, Namibia?
You're saying it perfectly, Namibian.
I love it. that's where you're from. That's in Africa, is that right?
Yes, that's Southwest Africa, so it's between South Africa and Angola.
Okay. What would a tourist like myself on a typical day in Namibia, how would you describe that? What would I experience? I think you actually shared some of it in a tribute song that you had done called Windhoek. I think that's right.
Yes.
Yeah,
yes,
you described what it was like. What would I experience on a typical day in Namibia?
Okay, probably it would be sunny for sure.
Mm-hmm. You say the sun is all year round?
Like 360 days of sunshine.
Oh my word.
And if people are lucky, there is some rain. But the past few years, it's been raining quite a lot, much more, because a desert country, let's say, and rain. There's a lot of drought going on, but the past few years, first of all, you'd see so many different kinds of people. It's a very mixed society. That's what I love most about it, basically. I love, experiencing...
Diversity.
Diversity.
Yeah.
I really love it. You know, your mind is kept open. What's most fascinating, inspiring for me in Namibia is nature.
Right, the landscape. Some of the photos that I've seen are just breathtaking. And so you walk out of your... You walk out of your doors and just look across the field and you start writing a song, don't you?
Yes, that's exactly what happened.
That's beautiful. Well, you're from basically the motherland, the birthplace of music and rhythm. How did all this influence you musically? How did you get started in music, Shoshani?
I'm from a very musical family. So my mother's Namibian, my father's Belgian. He moved to South Africa in the 80s, and from there went to Namibia, which was not Namibia yet. It was still part of South Africa, but in 1990 it became independent. So it was one of the last countries in Africa to become independent. And also had to do with apartheid, so the culture itself has quite something to deal with in terms of diversity and respect and all these things. But anyway, getting back to the question on how the music, my
I love
my
it.
Father,
give me the history. I love it. Give it to me.
He's a piano player, and I grew up with classical music every day of my life, basically. I have a brother who's a jazz piano player, and music was just infused, basically. So when I was 4 years old, I got sent to violin lessons, but then when I was around 10 years old, you know, classical music wasn't cool, and I wanted to listen to hip-hop and Tupac and all these things. So then I started playing drums.
Okay.
And that's what I did for a few years, and then when I was 17, I kind of stumbled, like, at a workshop, jazz workshop. Somebody caught me scatting, I guess, and then they said, why don't you try the singing department? And I was like, okay, sure. So I went there, and I just turned around. I looked at what other people were doing. I tried to join in, and I remember at the end of that workshop, it was a week, I guess, I had to sing a song. And the feeling it gave me to express myself with words, and also the reactions I got were so powerful that it just triggered something in me. Wow. Since then, I decided I wanted to sing.
Mm-hmm. The rest is history. Yes. I think you just mentioned three instruments that you play already. I mean, you're a multi-instrumentalist. What else do you play?
Yeah, well, the violin kind of slipped out of my historic memory. But, I love to play drums, and I started playing guitar 3 years ago, so... Just music, yeah, basically that's the only thing that really makes sense to me, you know, all the time. The rest is just one big question mark.
Satin Lounge, and speaking of her 2 year journey, let me just take you through it really quickly here. Satin Lounge, she, let's see, in 2011, Shoshani started the solo career she's talking about. And for the past 2 years, she's been just getting all these amazing accolades. She won the prestigious Last Band Standing competition in Namibia and was a headliner for the Windhoek
Festival.
Yes, in 2012.
I kind of rolled into the whole industry. One newspaper article got me on the radio, got me on TV, got me on the music awards. Since then, it was just like a snowball effect of performing and then getting so much, you know, positive reactions and attention.
So you're getting positive reactions and attention. One of the things that when I was kind of reading and learning more about you, one of the things that really concerned me was, you know, the climate and where you are, how you're an out indie artist and your messages are very strong in your music. For instance, the single Minority that we're talking about, did you receive any kind of political backlash when you became so popular? I mean, it's still illegal to be gay and from where you're from.
The thing is, I have maybe the advantage of being between cultures, let's say, because I grew up mainly in the Netherlands.